Hello and welcome back to Clannad. We're going to session 5 and all I can say is I've been enjoying this game profusely. Let's get back to where we last left off. Namely, April 17th. My breath is getting heavy. My lungs burn, starved for oxygen. My entire body is assaulted by an intense feeling of fatigue. I don't even know what it must look like to see me running. I come all the way here before even realizing that I practically sprinted down the street. Furukawa is standing directly in front of me. Furukawa. I direct myself toward her with shaky footsteps. Furukawa! I repeat her name as I call out to her.
Hey!
She replies, but I'm not able to say anything. What is it I want to do? She tilts her head to the side. I stand there, breathless. No, not really. The question finally caused me to remember it. The supermarket bag that I'm carrying in my hand, that is. Oh, this? You can have it. Furukawa takes it and peeks inside. It should be packed full of dango with little faces on them.
Dango daikazoku desu!
Yep, that's right.
Hontouni daikazoku desu!
Yep, one big family. Turn the volume down. Please get on my end. Yeah, well, why don't you ask them to join? Furukawa has a big smile plastered across her face as she continues to look keenly inside the bag. When I see her do this, I start to regain my composure before I know it. After that, the two of us stay in the park for a while. We sit down on a bench and stare out at the empty swings. I'm surprised by her sudden remark. Oh, what were you talking about this afternoon? They made me play catcher more often than that. You got that right. Drawing's never been something I could do. Not well, anyway, obviously. Yeah, whenever I draw anything, it always ends up deformed in some way.
Hi, so desu yo ne. Itsumo, itsu datte bukiyou de. So yatte, karakawaretari suru koto ga oukatta desu.
I peer at Furukawa's face. She's pressing against her cheek with both of her hands, as if she's trying to tolerate some sort of pain.
気づいたら一人でした。
I quickly realize that she's talking about what happened after school. She pulls me back up. No, that's not the right way to put it. All she did was smile, after all. But seeing her just do that was enough to bring me back to my senses. You know, in that case, is there something I can do for her to show my gratitude? If there's even a single thing, then maybe it wouldn't be so bad for us to be together. If you're just gonna be crying all alone otherwise, call me over. That way you won't have to be alone.
それは… 迷惑です、岡崎さんに。
That's not it, Furukawa. I want to be there. You wouldn't be causing me any trouble at all. There's no reason for you to act like that. Consider it when it comes to me. It's not a problem. I'm bored myself. Anyway.
わかりました。
Times like these calls for my glasses. All right, you do that. Yeah, that's important too. But if you didn't, I'd feel kind of sad and lonely. No, but I guess that'd be best. That would mean she's trying her hardest. I'm starting to confuse myself.
Huh?
It'd be boring. Sure, that'd be fine. I get bored otherwise.
Hey.
Just about the time my stomach starts to growl, I see two shadowy figures approach from the direction of Furukawa's home. I don't have to see their faces to know they're her parents. So, I greet them. Neither one of them get a single part of either one of my names right. They can call me whatever they want, it's totally cool. No, I'm fine with Galaxy or Universe. I'm fine with that. With a leap like that, you could compete in the Olympics. I get the feeling that no longer how long I know this man, the two of us are never going to have a proper conversation.
Okazaki-san, uchi ni agatte itte kudasai.
So そうだ。こんなところでこそこそ大変のように会ってんだね。
いや、待つ。
どうですか。それとも親御さんが心配されます。
That's not a problem, but Furukawa saved me today, so I'm gonna head home. I make my decision.
そっか、帰れ帰れ。
Yeah, nice seeing you too.
そうですか。残念ですね。また明日来てくださいね。
See you, Furukawa.
Hey!
All three of them answer. This family really is something.
おやすみなさいです、岡崎さん。
Hi. I look at Furukawa's smile until it embeds into. Let me read that again. I look at Furukawa's smile until it embeds itself into my mind's eye, then head back home for the night. And we go into the illusionary world again. Number two. Next, I see a floor. I'm staring straight at it. What was it?I feel like I was in the middle of something. I move my head up to change views. I see her. The girl that's been watching me. Her hand extends to me. I reach out my own hand out toward it. Our hands overlap. While I can't feel anything, I still know they're together.As this happens, I realize something. I really have been born into this world. I've ended up existing after all. She can touch me. It's a sad world. But she's kind. When I touch her hand, both sadness and kindness fill my heart at the same time. I was born into this place because I sought her.Sacrificing my life in a new world, the happiness I could have had, and everything else. She pulls my hand up so that I can stand, and leaves my side again. Once she's a few steps ahead of me, she claps her hands. I begin walking toward her. That's right, I was practicing walking. That's what I was doing before. My memory's sluggish. I can't remember anything without working to do so. She's clapping her hands still.Should go, but my legs don't move the way I want them to. I fall forward yet again, but even so, she takes my hand once more and pulls me to my feet. How many times have I tried to walk? Finally, I manage to reach her. She holds my body no more than half the height of hers in her arms. You did a good job. Warmth. This world.One source of warmth. The warmth that I sought. Though my body of scrap can't feel the warmth of hers. I look up at her face. There are so many things I want to ask her. But I have no mouth, so I can't speak. I'm not going to even bother getting into that joke.My face to the window. Light's constantly shining in through it. I want to see the outside world. I want to not look at the screen so much, especially with that light there. I want to see the end of the world for myself in my own eyes. Thank you. And now we reach Friday, April 18th. Rays from the morning sun spill into my room, my eyes singed by the ultraviolet glow. Why'd I wake up this early? I could still make it to school with plenty of time to spare. Well, it's not like I'm late to school because I want to be. I get out of bed, throw some clothes on, getting my day started a little earlier than usual. Stepping over my snoring father's body, I make a way through the living room and out the door. This is a strange sight. Lots of students from my school are walking about. And again, it's what it's supposed to be like. Greetings pass through the air as I stand there, but not a single person says hello to me. They all just walk by with smiles on their faces. I'm probably invisible to all of them. Which would also mean that if I were to just turn around and wander out, no one would stop me. Maybe I'll just run off somewhere. Someone tugs on my sleeve. So someone can see me after all. Whoever it is, they must be like me, another inhabitant of this invisible world. Oh, you're right, I had it wrong. I had a freaky dream, okay? Yeah, seeing them do that made me want to go the opposite way. Going to school side by side with a girl in this big of a crowd. Just the thought of it is enough to send a shiver down my spine. Go on ahead. You'll be late for class. We stay there for a while, and the number of students walking to school begins to visibly shrink. We're getting pretty tight on time.
Yeah?
Aren't we invisible anyway? Aren't we so unattractive and unimportant that no one would bother to pay attention to us in the first place? That's right. Midway up the hill, I see a girl standing there, staring into the sky. It's a face I recognize, making me stop instinctively. No, not really. Let's go. Time passes. Lunchtime. We're eating bread in our usual spot. Two weeks from now. That's when the drama club information session is going to be held. Well, the flyers do have the big dongle family on them. I hesitate for a moment, unable to answer.
Okazaki-san?
Yeah, I'm sure it'll be fine. All those dungo you release around school are sitting on their billboards, hard at work. Have some faith. Yeah, I think that's actually our problem. I make a quiet dig at Furukawa's extreme confidence. But seriously, why are those things popular to begin with? Looking back on it, it don't make any sense whatsoever. But it makes even less sense to be a, to still be a fan of it.
So, Okazaki-san.
What?
説明会って何をすればいいものなんでしょうか? Okazaki-san?
I've forgotten. She's not the kind of person who can just rise to the occasion and take care of this kind of thing on her own. Furukawa.
Hi.
Let's do some practice right now. Talk about whatever you want. I sit on the ground and give the instructions to Furukawa, who's standing in front of the chalkboard. She seemed to have some degree of awareness that she was the club leader. So she had taken the initiative and decided to stand there. If this were just a few days ago, she probably would have asked me to stand there in her place. She's really trying to be proactive about doing this. It's clear that this means a lot to her. Her actions confirm that. You can do this, Furukawa. I cheer her on inside my head. But... Instead of starting her speech, she just waves her hand to and fro, visibly squirming. At this rate, the first bell is going to chime before she even gets started. Hey, Furukawa.
Hi.
Looking at you now makes me wonder, how are you able to act in place? If she's this bad at talking and this susceptible to pressure, can she really expect prospective club members to take her seriously? I mean, who wants to join a drama club with a president that can't even overcome their nerves? Talk about a blatant discrepancy. So essentially, these phantom theatrical applicants would be faced theoretical. So essentially, these phantom theoretical applicants will be faced with not one, but two glaring problems. First, the big dongle family obsession, obviously. And second, a president who can't talk. And those aren't exactly small, easy to overlook qualms, either. Not like they would overlook them in the first place.
Okazaki-san?
Let me be straight up with you, Furukawa.
Hi.
You don't have any acting skill. So you're going to need to try like crazy.
Hi.
Which means you're going to need to practice for the information session for a while. And I do mean a while.
わかりました. 頑張ります.
She balls her hands and fists. At least she seems motivated. Keyword seems.
Ah, Tomoya!
Yo!
Doko itte ta no?
Just running an errand.
Hyotto shite, kore?
She raises her pinky and grins. It's nothing naughty like that. I guess I might actually be a pretty caring guy. You can if you want, it doesn't matter. Yeah, go ahead and laugh. Quit laughing! That was the slider. Huh? You're here? Well, you really shouldn't be. You're an eyesore.
Mudani
Oh, that's harsh. She can be here, it's okay, she's cool people.
もうよれもなったし、自分のクラスに戻った方がよろしいかと。本礼はまだでしょ?耳ちいこと言ってると、人としての器が知れるわよ。僕、耳ちいですか?みじんこ並みじゃない?
Hey, water flea, what's going on over there? Whatever, just answer me. I'm talking about the group of people over there. Not that I know who she is.
あそこは、委員長の席あたりだね。
Fujibashi, is there something we need to turn in? Fortune telling. What is? Are fortune that accurate? They are. They are. Yeah, you deserve that one. I don't know, that sounded so backhanded, sir. That was backhanded. Sunohara, ladies and gentlemen. Forever punched, forever kicked. He fails every exam. I saw them in your room. I found a bunch of them when I was fishing under your desk. What privacy? Check this guy out. He's concerned about that now. Thank you. But damn. You. Well, since you responded, wouldn't that be you?
お前のことかもしれないだろ?違うわよ。あんたのことよ。そうですか。そうです。で、何でしょう?
Yeah, I guess.
何占いなの?
What does she use, well? No, she uses playing cards. She uses cards. What, you want me to say she uses her boobs? She gets awfully specific with them, though. I'm sure it'll be useful. Sunohara enthusiastically walks toward the crowd. Eskyo and I see him off while smiling. Oi, go. I say to her with my eyes still fixed on Sunohara's back and my smile plastered on my face.
Nani?
Likewise, Kyo responds while watching Sunohara walk away. I think I'm starting to understand how your sister's fortunes work. I wonder what kind of fortune that loser's going to get. You're enjoying this, aren't you? Oh, that's better than myself. But yeah. Her passionate gaze is fixed up on his back, Sinahara continues forward. She chases away the crowd and steps in front of Fujibayashi. He then sits down at the desk in front of hers. She really uses his playing card, huh?
Mane.
Wouldn't she be better off using tarot cards? That's so. As Sinahara stares at her, Fujibayashi shuffles her deck of cards and drops it. Flustered, she starts to pick the cards up. She then forms a fan with the cards, and Sinahara picks out three. Fujibayashi stares at the three, and then says something to Sinahara. After she finishes, he nods. Looks like he received a good fortune.
No, you're me.
Guess the pathetic clown is back. Yeah, don't worry about it. So how'd it go? You know what? I'm taking that one right there. Dango Pedia term added. Great string of fate. We are definitely going to look at the Dango Pedia right after all this. He says and smiles in satisfaction. Well, not exactly right after this, but you know me. Joe and I look at each other. Although we didn't plan it, we both pat him on the shoulder at the same time.
どうしたのさ?頑張って。きっと未来は自分の手で変えることができるからね。
なんかよくわからないけど、thank you.
He gives us a thumbs up along with a bright smile. He's playing the part of the clown very well.
あれね。
Very much so. Yeah.
ん?なんかいた?
うん、気にしないで。
あ、そうだ。僕トイレに行くけど、岡崎も来る?
Alright. Go by yourself. No! There's no point in going if nothing's going to come out, right? Good lord, man, how old are you? Have fun. Sinahara gleefully accepts the results of his fortune and walks out the room with a strangely prideful look on his face. That's not going to last that long. His back looks darker than normal, like hinting at his grim future. The beginning of love will mark the beginning of a new life, huh? Huh? What's with that all of a sudden? Thought you would ask, huh? I wonder where she got that impression from. That's the usual bias you have there.
違うの?
At the very least, that's pretty hard to manage here at this school. You're asking for the teacher's attention by going out with a delinquent. That's not really why. There aren't any girls who are strange enough to want to go out with me now, are there? I know the feeling. Hey, I was the opposite of the delinquent. I was basically the straight A kid. The shaky straight A kid, because everything was like... And yet I squeezed out a 2.7 instead of a 3.2. Depends on the girl. I answer her after briefly considering it. Well, that's only natural. I have the right to pick who to go out with. Kyo considers my answer, her fingers covering her lips. She folds her arms and nods in agreement. So why'd you ask all of a sudden? That aside, what about you? You, if anyone, yourself. I know, that's why I'm asking. Yeah, what about you? Her smile freezes. Say something. A boyfriend or two. Right my foot. If you're trying to avoid a subject, that means you don't have anything to say. Nothing. I'm not trying to get a girlfriend either, don't get me wrong. That goes for you too. Suddenly in the classroom's door slides open and someone hurriedly runs inside. He trips in front of the teacher's desk and marvelously slides headfirst into the space between Kyo and me. All the dust on the ground is sent flying in the air. Oh, good lord. What the hell? Never mind. Found a new game to play, huh? Having fun? Sinohar pants heavily. As the drops of sweat run down his forehead, he looks toward the classroom entrance. Face first a bit. And you ran away because of that? I agree. You're the one who took it. You didn't have to take it, but you're the one who took it, bro. Okay, I'm sorry, but you know, Project Echo logic does not work here. It's almost the same as running it into a transfer student's he already said that. Right. Sinohara stays passionately and clenches his fist. So sure you do. What kind of dream does this guy have? If he's thinking about Project Echo, he is sorely mistaken. That's what I would like to know. So?
This guy is such an idiot.
So したらいきなり叫ぶんだぜ、泣きながらさ。
For help?
そこに。
そこに。All of a sudden the door slides open violently. And there stands, if I remember correctly, that's one of the third years from the rugby club. You can clearly see he's pretty pissed. Sonara lets out a soft shriek and hides behind me and kills.
Oi, この教室に金髪の野郎が逃げてこなかったか？人の彼女に突然不埒なことをした不届き者だ。
ごまかしてくれ。
Kyo and I take a step away from each other. Then we point at the space in between us.
そこかこれ。
おとおにと。
ちょっと便所までつらかせ。
Bye, Sunhar. This is the joys of doing visual novels sometimes. Sonar gets dragged out of the room. His life of hardships would come to an end.
死んじゃうのもある意味終止符よね。
Yeah. The two of us continue to gaze at the open door for a while. A bell rings to signal the start of afternoon classes. I take my seat, annoyed that I'm stuck at this desk for the next however long. Hearing the same sound, Kyo dashes out of the classroom. And time passes. Nobody cares about class.
Oi, Okazaki!
A voice calls out to me right as the period ends, but I quickly realize it's just my teachers. Like a good student! State Farm is there. I mean, I decided to ignore it.
聞こえないのか、Okazaki?
Ugh. He's so persistent. Why is it? I raise my hand while measuring him. A tone of distrust and annoyance hurt my voice. My homeroom teacher walks right up to me.
Sonohara wa doko da?
Sonohara. I look at the desk next to mine. It's right. Somehow it's not there. Who knows? What? Me?
So, お前だ、岡崎。
Why?
お前なら見当がつくんじゃないのかと思ってだよ。
Getting beat up, probably. Nope, nothing on my mind.
そうか。なら、お前を代わりに呼ぶことになるぞ。
Lovely. Where to?
もちろん職員室だよ。
Huh. Why?
岡崎、お前は自分の遅刻の数を知ってるのか
？I'm not as bad as Sinahara, though. At least I show up before lunch.
そういうの、50歩100歩と言うんだぞ。
Only in Japanese schools, ladies and gentlemen. Only in Japanese schools. Here in the U.S., we only get tardy. You get absence or tardy in high school. Tardy is totally different in Japan than it is here in the U.S.
とにかく、
その原がいないんだったら順番としてはお前になるんだよ。
What a depressing situation this is. I know, right? But that means that I can skip class after this? It seems wise to do just as he says and look for Sunohana. Okay, I understand. I'll go find him. Turn around and start walking.
Oi, Okazaki! 今からじゃないぞ! 授業が終わってからだぞ!
I pretend not to hear that last bit. Now I've got plausible deniability and can blame him if I get scolded for skipping out on the rest of the day. That's true! He never said go look for him later. He said go look for him. That's the difference. It's like, oh, if you look for him now, that'd be something, you know, different. So therefore, it would make sense. Like, well, you know what? The teacher, why are you skipping class? Oh, the teacher told me to look for this guy. I'm certain that Sunohara was around during lunchtime. But I'm not sure if he was around to take fifth period. I slept through the whole thing. Maybe the rugby team dragged him off somewhere? If that's the case, he's probably in some dark corner of the school now. Never to be seen again. The thought made me lose my will to find him. Wandering around at random is just getting boring. I began to think where he could be. Nothing comes to mind. Honestly, I don't really care where he is at this point. I'll go back. Just as I turn around, I remember something. There used to be a perfect place to nap in the old school building. It was the reference room on the first floor. I'll just go there. Probably best if I'm actually in class, even if I just sleep through it. Time passes. Even after classes are over, that idiot still doesn't show his face. It's nothing out of the ordinary for him, though, so I won't dwell on it much. I head to the drama club room by myself. As I do, Furukawa catches up to me. Before I realize it, the two of us are walking down the hallway side by side. Furukawa matches my pace. I can see it's hard work for her, but she's having fun doing it. We're not practicing a play, you know. We're practicing your introduction speech. I can't really say I know what you're talking about. Hey. Don't you think it'd be a good idea if you decided on what you're going to say ahead of time?
そうですね。暗記は得意ですから、それならできると思います。
I'm not going to help decide what to say or how to say it, though. I don't know a thing about drama. If anything, I'd want you to teach me about it.
私だって同じです。演劇をやりたいだけで、詳しいことなんて実は何一つ知らないです。
Okay. A bombshell has been dropped by the president of the drama club. Hey, Furukawa.
Hi.
Why do you want to be in plays?
好きだからです。
Can't get much more logical than that. What about them do you like?
楽しいと思いました。みんなで演技するのって。私、小さい頃から学芸会とかそういうのことごとく欠席しちゃって。だから絶対演劇部に入ろうってそう思ってたんです。3年間演劇頑張ろうって。でも1、2年生の頃はそれどころじゃなくって、3年生はずっと休んじゃって。
Yeah, I guess that makes sense. In other words, Her enthusiasm for being in plays is basically just a desire to work with others in the group. She wants to be part of something where everyone comes together to accomplish a single common goal. Much like the situation that I'm in right now. And by doing that, she then be able to realize a dream that has gone unfulfilled all this time. That's all. Furukawa lets out a small sigh, then presses her hands to her chest. She must have spoken for too long. She seems tired. She's this frail, this fragile. Yet she's trying to charge forward. How could you ignore her seeing after? How could you ignore her after seeing that? I certainly wouldn't be able to. You pass. So I tell her that. Just use that as your speech, what you just said. It's kind of short, but I get this feeling that you were able to say exactly what you wanted to there. No, I'm serious. I'm not the kind of guy to beat around the bush. I'm very blunt. Thank you. Yeah, so you can believe me when I say that. The only problem is whether you'll be able to say the same thing when it's time for the actual meeting. You tend to fold under pressure, right? The question that pops in my mind next loops all the way back around to the beginning of our conversation. Then how are you going to be able to act in place? Furukawa continues to practice for the information session. We decided to end it on that note. Her words are clumsy, but I have a good feeling about her tone. Eager. Genuine. Question. I raise my hand pretending to be a new student. What kind of plays are we going to do? There are lots of different kind of plays out there, though I don't know what they are. This is probably the one thing that any potential applicant would want to know most. She thinks for a bit. There are a bunch of different kinds, right? Like fairy tales for kids or musicals for adults? I'm going home. Give me an answer then. Just say something. Now that's what I call a vague answer. So ones that make you laugh? Comedies? Something in between. Plays that make you cry? Funny or sad, which is it? She's trying to cover for her with a smile. Oh, whatever. Well, I'll say this. You at least gave it a shot. If you clam up, you'll just make people nervous. So as long as you're sincere about trying to answer their questions, they'll at least be able to see your type. That's about all you have going for you right now, after all. We continue practicing for another hour or so. But I think now's a good time to actually stop here, so... I'm gonna say like a soul. And next time, we shall continue this and possibly move on to, say, the weekend. Because I have no idea how long this is actually going to be, but hey! More filler, go figure. More story, go figure. So stay tuned, more of Clannad right after this.